Welcome. This is Hiran Sari. Today I'm going to show you the exact location of Machu Picchu I have discovered in the light of Quranic verses and Bible verses and so many and different maps and so many detailed in-depth research, web research. So let's continue. But before continuing, kindly don't forget to subscribe my channel and like this video if you like it. Also share it. It is very important. And watch it till the end. You will find so many. So this is the video. This is the location. This is Machu Picchu, the mountains area, Cusco, in Cusco, Peru. And this is these are three different mountains. Two mountains: Haina Picchu Mountain and Patacosi. Picchu means also it is called. Picchu means mountain in Spanish, and this is Machu Picchu. Machu Picchu means old mountain, and this is the top view of the Machu Picchu. Here, this is Urubamba Canyon. This is Patacosi Mountain. This is Sungate, not exactly here, but backside of this mountain. There is Sungate. This is Citadel Valley, Machu Picchu's second valley. Here, you will find the sun mirrors, the muddy waters. Bowls where sun mirrors where they used to the sun worshippers used to see the sun setting reflection of the setting sun, and here they used to get the rays of the rising sun when on the sun rising time. Okay, so in the Quranic verses it is said that the sun was setting in the muddy water. He saw sun setting in the muddy water, and he reached to the place where on sunrise. Okay, so it was not the place. In Arabic, it is not place not mentioned. It can be the limit or the time of sunset and time of sunrise, not the place. Okay, so this is Patacosi. This mountain was exactly the mountain which was pulled to shrink the hole of the Gog Magog wall. So here you can see that this was I added this image and made it pull back that mountain, and I have marked this place. This is exactly the Gog Magog hidden path tunnel to the Gog Magog world. So here I have mentioned all these things with the help of maps. There are some ancient maps, the eye of the Illuminati eye, and some other things that can be that are setting well on this location. You can see this is the cube, and this is the Illuminati eye of Horus. The Horus is the god of Freemasons and the Antichrist. Also the Illuminati. This is Illuminati, pure Illuminati eye. And this eye is called, this is this formula. These numbers are very ancient numbers. This was eye was made as a formula, proportion formula, by the ancient Egyptians as a hieroglyphs in their hieroglyphs language. So all these numbers, this marked in the points are very important. In some of the images you will see that these numbers are pointing here and here. And here, because they don't know that these are the hidden signs, why the numbers are in this location. These all are important. So marking the numbers here and here doesn't make that location perfectly set. So this map is exactly setting all the locations. All these numbers are setting on important places. I will show you. This is the center of the cube, the main tunnel area. In the Stargate, you will also see. In the Stargate movie, it is also said that the cube, the main, the seventh point, the missing point should be here to go in the other world, in the center of the cube. You can see that this is placing exactly, these two things are placing exactly here, pointing to this area. This eye image also, or this portrait also, So this is this path is going to the top of the Machu Picchu from where the portrait was taken, the image was taken. So this is the sign, and this is going to the Sun Gate exactly. But it will set exactly on in the Google Map view. You will see it in the right way. So I'm going to show you it in Google Map also. And this I will show you the portrait also. The portrait setting on that image is very well set. Okay, so you can see this portrait. This is Egyptian god portrait pointing to the mountains where the Antichrist is kept. So it is said that these are three mountains, pointing to three mountains or three pyramids. So they used to find it, search it on in Egypt. They don't know that this image or all these things are setting here in these ancient mountains. These are very, very suspicious and very mysterious mountains range. And there is a face of a half man here also, like the Jal, the Antichrist. And there are so many other faces and other things, and walls, tunnels that make this area suspicious, mysterious. Here you can see this is Google Map, and here you will see the eye. I have set the eyes exactly on this location. Here is the top of the Machu Picchu from where the picture was taken and the view was seen, the portrait view. So you can see this one by 64, this route is going to this path, is the path from the top of the Machu Picchu to that Patukusi. And this is 132 is 1/32 set, is setting exactly on the Sun Gate, Puerta del Sol. And this 1/4 is setting to the exact location, the tunnel, because in that location the tunnel is setting on different way here, but when you set it in the Google Map view, this number is pointing to that tunnel. And this is the location where it is marked by Hiram Bingham, who discovered this location, these mountains. So they marked it here because other people are also searching for looking this as a map, and they are trying to find the location. So they thought that this tunnel, just like I used to thought that this tunnel in other picture was setting here, but in this picture Google Map view it is setting here. So that picture is only one of its kind now, the portrait, because no one took that picture in this angle. Only in that Sam's travel people have taken that picture, and I utilized that picture for map view. So it was absolutely set, fitting on the place. But this Sun Gate was not placing perfectly, and I was not aware of this 1/64 meaning. So I got that this is from the top view, exact view of that in these mountains locations. And this is the part to the in these mountains, and this is Sun Gate, and this is maybe the there is something hidden, important thing hidden. This is the top of the Machu Picchu. And here you can see this is also an important place. Here we will have to find something, and when you will zoom in, and you will see that there is some thing in the vegetation. So here something important to find, here something important to find, here is the tunnel of the Gog Magog, and here maybe we will also find something, maybe in the number, this number, or maybe this is just for the path. And this is the sun mirrors pointing to the sun mirrors, there is also their sacred tree, acacia tree, and there is also the sundial in this place. There is sun gate, maybe here or maybe here. Sorry, sun gate was not here, sun gate is here. Sorry, on that image it was showing there on the portrait view. Okay, so these are the points, these are very important. One thing I will also like to mention, that there was the Horus. Who was Horus? Horus was actually the Antichrist. According to the Illuminati's, he was the son of the first Pharaoh. The Pharaoh, exactly not from the Egyptian chain, but it was the Aeneid gods, one of the Aeneid gods, Osiris. He was the son of Osiris, and Osiris was first mummified in Egypt. And so his mummy is also kept maybe with Horus. So maybe if we find this location, maybe we will find the mummy also, and some hidden more important things here. And the Antichrist is also said that he is kept in the north of the Gog Magog, and the Gog of Magog, the prince of Tubal and Meshech, is kept in the north of, so the north from the Palestine, where the Bibles, the Torah and the other Bibles were sent. So the north of this is Peru. Here you can see the Quranic verses in English translation, the muddy spring. So you can see that this muddy, the sun mirrors are made with mud and water. So we can see them muddy, muddy water mirrors. And somewhere, if it is a spring, so there is aguas calientes. There is hot water spring also in some translations. And so there are aguas calientes. There is a big eye-shaped pond also there to use it as a, utilize it as a sun mirror. So there are so many things that are resembling with that ayat, that word, Aina Huma. So please, I would like someone to start researching on it. And if you want to contact me, you can find my contact in my about page. My channel name is Hiran Sari, Learn with Hiran Sari on YouTube. And the handle is Hiran Sari. And you can find my contacts in the contact page. I would like someone come ahead and start researching on it. I'm really sure that they will find a lot of things here, hidden things in the location. And there are so many things they can find here. This is tunnel, the main Gog Magog wall, the tunnel on the earth, the base, not in the horizontal, it's not vertical, it's horizontal tunnel. Okay, underground, going underground. And this is the important place, this is the important place, this is the important place. They can find so many things here, hidden things. Maybe they will find something here also. All these places are very important. These marks are meaningful. Nothing is meaningless. Maybe there is a place where the mountain was when it was pulled, somewhere there will be maybe a mark of pulling, like there was a separation between these two mountains, when stretched between these two mountains, they can find. And maybe this is sign that there is something like that to find, and that will prove that the mountain was moved from its place. So let's see and try to explore it in real, and let me be a part of your research. Thank you. Bye for now.